Hello there and welcome to today's video. I am Dan and today we take a look at Tenderfoot Tactics. That is a turn-based strategy RPG where you take control over a pack of goblins on the quest to fight back the fog. And also answering the question if this is an easy turn-based game to play. Sounds like fun? Then you know what you have to do. Grab your cup with your favorite drink. This is the Grog, by the way. Adjust your chair for optimal coziness and let's slide into this review. Alright, if you just stumble upon this video, I say welcome, and if you click this video in search of finding out more about this game, I shall be your guide and I promise you it won't take more than 6 minutes to give you an in-depth look of what it's all about, so let's start this journey now. For a generation, the terrible fog, one vast, voiceless and cruel spirit, has been eating the once thick forest on the mainland. Now, with nowhere left to call home, and granted magic by the friendly spirit of the archipelago, one small party of would-be adventurers sets out. Find a way to save the many goblin towns of the rocky coast, discover the truth about the fog, and if it's possible, put an end to it. No pressure there, right? So after a quick chat with a pretty unhelpful spirit, a spirit you can actually fight when you just casually stand around minding your own things, dropping a casual meow here and there, but more about that later. You then set off with a small pack of goblins to explore the island, and if you are lucky, you might even find another goblin pack to fight pretty soon. But before we dive into the fighting aspect of the game, let's just go through some basics on how to keep a goblin pack happy in 2020. You can equip your goblins with different items that have either damage or health bonuses, and that is, in the regard of itemizing to keep track of, a really simple and awesome way to solve it. You can of course set skill points that you acquire by leveling up your goblins through acquiring XP from farming bushes and flowers that are marked with an icon, and of course through good old fighting. The low polygraphic style of the game is really smooth and it even has a retro mode if you prefer to play it old school. But I get it, you and your goblins sometimes have a hard time knowing where to go, so with no flying mount in sight you can always call on the bird. I called mine Diablo from the Disney Sleeping Beauty. Quick side note though, you cannot actually name it in-game, so don't go looking for that setting. But it's not like the bird vision of Assassin's Creed, so you can't fly far and wide, but it gives you a bit of understanding of your surroundings and help you navigate both on land and on sea. There are a lot of places to visit, like different islands, and you do that with your trusty boat. It looks really good and you can just walk down to the water to achieve it. But if you like to travel on land with style, find a high point, take a group of goblins on an unforgettable slide down the slopes and right into battle. Ah, we have ourselves a fight, and perhaps this is what you came here for. So let's dive into the basics right away. You start your turn with placing out your units, and you can also decide in what order they will later on execute their turns. Every unit may act and move once per turn. And as you can see from the gameplay, the terrain is not flat, and that can be something you can make good use of. There are impassable objects like trees to hide behind, but you can also create ways of forcing the enemy into areas that are to their disadvantage. Just remember that steep slopes, thick bushes, and deep waters are considered difficult terrain, so you will only get one move per square. Another thing to consider is that if you attack an enemy in difficult terrain, your attack can break the bush that is slowing it down and dramatically change the outcome of the fight. You have your melee units and your range units to fight for you, and a good thing to know is that when you decide to move them, you will see an outline in yellow where they will be able to attack after they moved. And you end your turn with deciding where to point your goblin. And why is that important? Well, if you have them facing the wrong way, the enemy attacks are more effective. The same goes if you can attack from behind on an enemy, so flanking is pretty effective. There are two different outcomes from a fight. Let's start with the fun one. You win, hooray to you! You get some new gear as a reward and sometimes even some goblins that will want to join your ranks on your amazing journey. They seem to be polite goblins, so they don't seem to be overly focused on overturning you or eat you, so that is great. And what happens when you lose? First of all, you get a choice to either replay the fight or just leave. If you leave, you're sent back to the last town you camped, so if you are traveling far and wide and come upon a village, remember to camp so you have a new starting point for these occasions. Since it's really easy to just sail away, run off into the land, and suddenly become a juicy meal delivered to a hungry pack of stronger goblins, so is this an easy turn-based game to play? I would say yes, you don't have a lot of different units to keep track of, nor is the gearing of your units overly complicated. The challenge comes from you trying to read how the enemies will behave and attack while you keep your goblins alive. But it's not too easy either. It offers to upgrade for your goblins and also a more in-depth manipulation of the environment as you are busy fighting. So if you are looking for a chill but graphical smooth game sprinkled with nice colors that have high replayability, then this is the game for you. The background music is a bit off the walls, but if you focus on the gameplay, it slowly fades away. I am Dan, it's been a pleasure showing you Tenderfoot Tactics. I hope you now have a better view on what this game is all about, and it can assist you in the decision of getting this game or not. My channel is all about showing you some of the best indie games out there and sharing my passion for that kind of games with you. If you stay for the end screen, I have another game in the same genre for you to experience. And until next time, stay safe and stay awesome.